Forbade, they can really make you made.
The Citizens Advice Bureau is where you talk and we listen.
Other things just make you swear and curse.
But here on Cab Talk, we talk and you listen.
The Citizens Advice Bureau.
For your free, helpful advice.
When you're chewing on life's gristle, that grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best.
Cab Talk.
And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing when you're feeling in the dumps.
Good morning, Wesley, and welcome once again to another session of Cab Talk.
Yes, good morning, Moira, and it is good to be here.
It
has been a bit of a hassle, but we're on air again.
We are. Yeah. It seems to be a strange year this year. I don't know where it's gone.
Well, we're almost halfway through.
Yep.
And we're thinking of all the things that can make us more comfortable, and how all these different things that are cropping up in people's lives. So we are now today having a session on
just us. Yeah, I think, is it a seasonal thing? Do you think it every so often we need to take a breather and just be just us? Because I think we've both probably been busy in the last few weeks, months.
Yes.
And I think we've sort of, like we both said today, it was just nice to be just us.
Well, yes, but we've got to think hard
and
give you all the information that we can. And first of all, we need to tell you that Citizens Advice is a free, confidential service for the citizens of this country, New Zealand.
And I suppose CAB, that would probably be worldwide, where CAB
originated.
Yes.
In the UK.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, and I think this confidentiality is quite a tech word at the moment, isn't it? And I think because probably the social media is so much out there.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yes.
That it's nice to know that when people come to us, call us, walk in, or
yes,
through the emails now, that it's all treated with respect and confidence.
Yes, and we certainly expect a reciprocal. When people come as clients, we treat them with respect, we give them privacy, we help them with their problems, and we expect them to respect the fact that we are volunteers and that we do it out of the well-being of the community, don't we?
Yeah. It's quite interesting because people say, why are you a volunteer at CAB? And I thought, oh, that's a good question, really. Mm-hmm. And I suppose it's just probably, I think, all of us who work there, probably just because we like helping other people out.
Yes, we've got a great team. We get on well. We're all from different walks of life.
Mm-hmm.
And we've got a fantastic guy who does a roster for us, and tries to mix us up so that we get to work with each other. And the strengths and the talent that the people in our bureau have got is just amazing. Yeah,
we are very lucky, actually. And I think because we're sort of probably one of the or two of the old heads now at the CAB, we've probably seen a lot of people come and go.
Unfortunately, yes, that happens. But
they have left a mark, you know.
Yes.
And positive marks. It's not all, you know, we're not actually with them. It's quite interesting. But yeah, CAB, what do we actually do?
Well, you've picked out a subject to start with. Social justice.
Right,
yes.
I'm going to have some music and we'll have a pre-read of it before we start going back. sorry for that technical problem there. I think some of the controls buttons were changed, and you may not have heard the first part of that song.
Well, I think people need to realise that this is we are amateurs. We haven't got all the people in the background doing all the dubbing, mixing, and whatever. Moira's the one, or two-armed bandit there, doing all the controls, and I'm shuffling paper and trying to keep up with everything. So, you know,
we're human.
CAB is a champion for people's rights. Now, this is one of our mottos, know your rights.
Yes.
And we try our very best to help you to know your rights, and working to help you with the underlying causes of problems that, you know, you may face. So that's one of the things that we think is important, that everyone in New Zealand can participate in their community and access the services that they need.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I think in lots of ways is actually we're empowering people.
Yes. Yeah.
Exactly. You know, and because often most people come to us because they have a situation and they can't resolve.
Yes.
And often it's when they start to talk about it and have another pair of ears listening.
Yes.
And so, like, I suppose we've all got a background now of what we need to know to resolve issues. So we're actually probably, there to help them out.
Yeah.
We don't actually do the work. We just basically give them the stepping stones of being able to empower themselves to resolve it.
It is true. We don't know everything, and we certainly don't use it straight off the top of our head. Sometimes people will say to me, "Oh, Wesley, you work at CAB. What do you think of this? You know, can you tell me what you should do here, there, or something else?" And I said, "Well,
contact the CAB."
From what I know, you should ask somebody or look it up, and that is the great thing about our new website that's been launched. There's just so much information on it for people, and there's also a area where you can email us, but also there's a chat box where you can write in a question and it'll come back to you with some sort of reply.
Now, that's going to go a little bit technical for me, obviously.
I haven't tried it out because I'd be fake in a way if I put in the chat box, as a general citizen. I would be not asking a question that I really needed and it would be a sort of false thing, but it's all a new system that is being updated as we find little cracks in it, and this is all done through national office, and it also gives you some of the funders that help national office to function in a nationwide, and one of the funders that we work closely with, and it comes back to the social justice, is the Ministry of Business and Innovations. And so our service, getting back to social justice, provides us with a unique information about issues affecting people in the communities nationwide. And every time a person seeks CAB help, we record what they sought the help about and what they did in responses. We don't always know what they've done in response because we don't actually impede on their personal life or ask them for information after they've been, because it's confidential. We only record the actual problem. We don't record the name of the person. We only record their problem and what we suggested, or gave the information that we had to to them.
Mm.
So that when they come to us, they need not worry about somebody else finding out who they were, what they, why they came. That is totally confidential.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we do keep stats, but the stats is more on, as you said, the inquiry, age group, location.
Yes.
And that often indicates where the problems are arising. If it's a let's say something that keeps arising at a certain age or yes, a certain location.
Absolutely, yeah.
That the national office, they actually go through it and they can actually start, I suppose they keep their stats, and when it becomes obvious to them that there are some issues going on, they then take action and start digging out a bit more, and then they actually get in touch with the government. They actually submit their findings to the government.
Yes.
And it can actually have a huge effect on social policies. So the CAB is actually, I suppose, we're used as an agency in a way of highlighting what is actually going on in the community.
Exactly. We are independent, but we use the insights gained from these inquiries to show when government policies and laws or the implementation of these as having a negative impact on people's throughout Aotearoa. And we argue for positive social change.
Yeah, and I think we could actually, I suppose, pat ourselves on the back, because I know that the homelessness issues, that it actually, one of our workers actually raised it with National herself, and so I say, look, I've got concerns. We seem to be getting a number of these same inquiries, which had actually activated National a lot faster and saying, well, let's have a look more. And it, and I think actually, I mean, we can honestly say that CAB was on television quite a bit in regards to the homelessness as well. So that is probably one of the ones that publicly people could see.
Yes.
CAB at work. And of course, the other one is consumers.
Right. Yeah. Yes, definitely. Yeah. And employment as well. Yes.
But I think you often hear about CAB and consumers.
Yes.
Rights and what's happening and things like that. Yeah. Yeah. I must admit, it's quite amazing. As you say, we don't give out any answers until we check first. And often things change for us, that when we go in to get the answer, we thought, oh, that changed from last time. So that's just a way of us keeping us on our toes as well, that we cannot just rhyme it off our heads, really.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I mean, I still have trouble remembering the CAB phone number. So well, why don't I give it to you now? 06377 0078, or pop down to see us at 43 Perry Street in Masterton. You can email us at wairarapa@cab.org.nz. And we answer them back. Just be aware that Saturday and Sundays we are closed.
Yes, and we are open from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday to Friday. We do put a notice if we're closed for any reason. So we do appreciate the fact that people need to know that we do sometimes have to close early for certain reasons. And we're not open on statutory holidays or things like that.
And if you do walk in, and we do have a private interview room.
Yes.
So that we do take you away into the interview room. And yeah, so it is all private. And I think we keep on about this confidentiality and privacy, but to us it's really, really important.
Oh, it is. Yes, definitely. We are doing a bit of an upgrade in the next step. Well, quite a major one. We're going to be busy working at the Bureau, doing some painting and putting up, using some new poster display units. And so we will probably be be closed for one Friday afternoon so we can move all our stuff out and get cracking on the painting.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be all exciting. Hands to the work. We've got, I think we've got at this stage 29 volunteers that work on rosters at CAB, so we won't all be working there at the same time, but over Queen's birthday weekend we're going to have a major working bees to get ourselves looking quite different. Yes.
Wow. Watch this space. Right, let's some more music then. Let's hopefully I can get the sounds working this time.
I'll be alone each and every night. While you're away, don't forget to write. See you.
Oh, Wesley, I think I've gone really, really back in time. Golden, olden oldies. Right, Wesley, what else have you got to say today?
This has come out from the Ministry of Social Development. Need help with housing this winter. No one in need of housing should be left out in the cold this winter. And this is the latest that's come out. So we want to make sure that everyone has somewhere warm, dry and safe to live, and all New Zealand have the support they need. If you or anyone you know needs help finding a place to live or paying the accommodation, please call us on 0800 559 009 to talk about your options. This is an issue that affects every town in the country, and it's not easy in the Wairarapa to find housing. It's people tell us that they ring that number or they ring an agency looking for accommodation, and they just aren't able to get it. So we need, if you have a problem and you come to us, we will do our level best to put you in contact with an agency that may be able to help you. But it is a big problem all over New Zealand, and these statements that come out are reassuring, but we're not sure about how many houses are actually free in the community for people.
It is a very, very difficult area, actually, in working and trying to find someone with housing. I mean, because it's not just availability of housing, it's the cost of housing as well.
Yes.
And, you know, some people just cannot afford the rents. I mean,
no.
You know, some of the rents is like $300 plus a week. And for some people, that's most of their wage.
Yes.
You know, and it is difficult. But as I say, I think we are now more aware of the housing difficulties and there is more input into that issues.
Yes, and if someone comes to us, we don't know how work and income without looking up the data on their website of what the criteria is for giving you grants to go to pay your rent and how you can pay it off in installments so that whoever you're renting from knows that you're going to pay that. For instance, the bonds can be horrendously high and very hard to build up enough money to pay a bond even without the 200 the 2 weeks advance rent in advance. So when you come to us with something like that, we will look up the latest through the work and income website and give you some pointers of where to go and how to approach. And I think that's the hardest thing, is people don't know actually how to approach a subject when they go to an agency like Work and Income.
It's knowing what questions to ask, isn't it?
It is.
When you go to there. And I think there is, because there is different types of funding for different areas. I mean, there's the housing, I think, funding. They talk about grants. They talk about, you know, all this ways, I suppose, of wording things that can be confusing to people.
Yes.
And I think it also depends, I mean, whether you have to enroll in the social housing or things like that as well. Real estates are really working alongside now. Unfortunately, they do keep the history of tenants as well, so that can have an impact on individuals.
Excuse me. One of the things that comes to mind that happens has happened to it seems to be a trend. People have had a bad credit rating, and so when it comes to getting a rental property, they find they can't because of their history. And how can they get that name taken off the bad credit rating? It is possible, but you need an agent, you need somebody with experience to help you do that. And I know that I'm pretty sure I know Work and Income expect you to have done some budgeting service to go to an agency that helps you to budget and to see that you can manage your money, or if you can't get the budgeting service has the ability to help manage your funds. And with that in mind, that is the first stepping stone to getting your name cleared as a bad debt.
I think, you know, the budget agencies in Marston, they actually do work with the clients. They work along with them.
Yes.
And they don't take over. They work with them.
Yes.
And they go through individuals' budgets and they set the budgets. And then their support is there to the individual needs.
Mm.
And then hopefully over a period of time, their support lessens. Because, you know, when people are in dire strait and they're starting from nothing, it takes a lot to build up or a lot to catch up on.
Yes.
But once they've got to past that stage, they can then start, I suppose it's empowering them as well.
Well, I'm just thinking myself, it's a bit like wanting to go on a diet and you think, oh, crikey, I won't eat today, and I won't and I cut out all the carbs, and you go mad for a week, and you then you think, well, it's nothing much
changed.
Gone off.
Yeah, nothing's changed.
Nothing's changed. Yeah. Whereas when you go into budgeting, it's a gradual thing, and you can allow yourself days when you do cut back, and you make sure that you. But then when you start to see some results, and they're not quick, they take time, and those sure and steady ways are much better than the crash diet, if you want to call it that.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I think we've sort of got to, you know, not think that it's people who are on benefits who require that service. Often there's a change in your life. I mean,
yes,
you could lose your job for no apparent reason. And then all of a sudden you're struggling to pay your mortgage, pay your rent, pay for the car, pay for all the other things. Mm. And really that's a time you want to go to the budget people, because they can actually sit down and perhaps work through with you and help you prioritise things as well.
Yes. Yeah.
It's, I think, money is my dad always used to say, money is the curse of all evil. And I think in some ways he is, because we all get funny over money. We do, don't
yes.
we?
Yes, well, that you know, can
we,
happen.
Yeah, we yes. get reactions that, you know, we either have not enough, or we would like more, or, you know, there's always something, isn't there?
I think people say that no matter how much you've got, you always want some more.
Mm.
And that can be the case when you see people who have actually won a huge amount of money. And there are stats that show that within so many years, they're back to square one.
Yeah, it would take some management, you know, and it's quite sad, but then again, as long as they've enjoyed it, I suppose that's something. But yeah, it's a funny old thing, money. It really is, really, you know, and it doesn't make the world go round. I don't think it does. I think it actually creates a lot of issues and problems, and stuff. And then again, and greed. And everything else, you know, there's a lot of good, but there's a lot of bad as well.
Yeah.
And again, we were not going to be debating today. Right.
No, we don't. Well, we have our own opinions, but we are neutral on what we and how we, we're non-judgmental at Citizens Advice.
Yeah.
And we do try very hard to help people no matter how small or how large the inquiry is. And the other thing that I like to say to people is that if you don't succeed the first time and you feel that we haven't given you enough information, don't be frightened to come back. The door is always open. Well, in the winter time, it's actually closed because, you know, when you have the heater going, but we don't sit there in the cold with all the woolies on. Well, we could do, but we have the heaters going, and it's welcoming, and we are happy if you come back. In fact, we enjoy it if you come back, because then we know we can really help you.
Yeah, and often it is, as I said, I call it the stepping stones, and I think it is stepping stones, because often we've got to take a few steps. Or, you know, even when you're crossing a river, you may go across on a stepping stone, but often you step backwards and try and another stone, don't you?
Yes.
Yeah. And it's a bit like that. I mean, that's life in general.
Yeah.
And then often, you know, when you've resolved one thing, you discover there's another issue that you've got to resolve. Again, it's just life.
Yes.
Yeah. We don't judge. I mean, I think that's the biggest thing. When people come in, we respect you for coming in, and we don't judge.
No.
We just get on with it. Yeah. We're getting very serious today. So let's have some music.
Pies in the buttermilk, 2x2. Pies in the buttermilk, 2x2. Pies in the buttermilk, 2x2. Skip to my darling. Oh, she's gonna get a skip to me. Yeah, she's gonna get a skip to me. Yeah, she's gonna get a skip to me. Skip to my darling. If you can't get a red bird, a blue one will do. If you can't get a red bird, a blue one will do. If you can't get a red bird, a blue one will do. Skip to my darling. Oh, she's gonna get a skip to me. Yeah, she's gonna get a skip to me. Yeah, she's gonna get a skip to me.
dibbity, my darling. I lost my girl, now what'll I do? I lost my girl, now what'll I do? Lost my girl, now what'll I do? Skip dibbity, my darling. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Yeah, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling. Well, I'll find another one, a better one too. I'll find another one, a better one too. I'll find another one, a better one too. Skip dibbity, my darling. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Yeah, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling. We'll keep it up till half past two. Keep it up till half past two. We'll keep it up till half past two. Skip dibbity, my darling. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. She's gonna get skip dibbity. Yeah, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling. You stole my fun, skip dibbity. Stole my fun, skip dibbity. You stole my fun, skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Yeah, she's gonna get. Skip dibbity, she's gonna get skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling. Yeah, she's gonna get skip dibbity. She's gonna get skip dibbity. She's gonna get skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling. Oh, she's gonna get skip dibbity. She's gonna get skip dibbity. She's gonna get skip dibbity. Skip dibbity, my darling.
There you are, Skip Dibbity, a little bit old, jaded version, but hey, we'll get it there, Wesley.
Right. Well, don't talk about us like that.
That's true. That's true. I think I'll look at some different music for next time.
Well, people would have heard on the news that the national body was having a shortfall in funding. It came through as a notice to us all, and it was public. We'll be pleased to know that they have had the funding from another source, so they are very pleased to announce that they're on budget. But you know that we're all trying to get the same dollar, and there's just so many different agencies out there all trying to get the money from the same similar places. So I'd like to put a big thank you out to these supporters and agencies and charities that give funding to the Citizens Advice Bureau. It's certainly on our website, the contributors to supporting us, and it's most important to the running of our bureau. Yes.
Mm-hmm. It certainly is. And I think, you know, that there is a lot of volunteers, agencies, you know, out there. I mean, and I think it's in the hundreds.
Yes.
You know, and it is difficult. I mean, maybe it's as an indication of showing where the needs are needed.
Yeah.
New Zealand's a small country, small population.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have to do a lot. You know, by volunteers to be able to get things done in a way.
Yeah.
You know, so hats off to, you know, New Zealand, but it is difficult out there for funding, and society means that we have to pay the rent like everybody else.
That's right. And while we're talking about rent, I've got the a printout from Tenancy, Government Rent Bond and Bills. And you can look it up on www.tenancygovernment.nz, rent, bond and bills. And it is a, you know, it's one of those responsibilities that you have to, and it's happened throughout the ages, tenants and landlords need to know what to do when rent is overdue and where they can go for help.
Mm.
So if tenants don't pay the rent on time, it is a breach of the tenancy agreement and the Residential Tenancy Act. The tenancy agreement will say how the rent is to be paid and when.
Mm-hmm.
So when you rent, you take that agreement out, and it's your responsibility.
Yes, yeah, and it is. I mean, it's no different if you're paying rent or a mortgage.
Yeah.
You know, it's the same principle. You've taken out a contract or agreement that you abide to pay, and that's just the way it is.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it goes on to say, if there are multiple tenants and one of them causes the rent payment to be missed or short, all other tenants are responsible for the overdue rent. Mm. And they will have to pay the debt if the offending tenant doesn't.
Mm.
So, you know, there's that responsibility. It's not a... it's probably in a flatting situation that could happen.
So that could be termed as a collective agreement within the flat people that they're all responsible and paying their share of the rent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If someone else shares the house but they are not named as a tenant on the tenancy agreement, they're likely to be a flatmate.
Mm.
Flatmates pay rent to the tenant. They're not part of the tenancy agreement and they're responsible to the tenant, not the landlord. So this is something that happens when young people go flatting or a group of people go into a flat together. And there's a good article on the difference between tenants and flatmates.
Mm.
And I think that people that go into a flatting agreement have to have a flatting agreement, a flatting situation. And I can't understand why all flatmates aren't on the tenancy agreement.
It is questionable because I think for some reason, maybe when they go into being, you know, to rent, that they think, all right, everybody's responsible for X amount of payment. And if they don't pay, we'll just tell the landlord and he can chase it up. But doesn't quite work like that, does it?
No.
Some landlords will take on that responsibility and, you know, and go to the person who owes it, but it's still equal responsibility for everyone in that in the tenancy agreement. And another one is, if you don't get them on a tenancy agreement, you're then, if they leave, you know, you're liable for a lot more as well.
Yes.
You know, you need to safeguard yourself. It's probably one of those things that we would probably advise parents to actually inform the grown-up children to be, to come to the CAB and pick up information on a tenancy services. Yes.
Well, young people today are pretty savvy on computers and looking everything up. One of the important things is for them to know where to look.
Mm.
We have these little cards at CAB that we compiled, but we need to go through them and check that the information on them hasn't changed, because all these things change. Mm. But most of it is to do with things that young people might need when they go and leave home. Most of the young kids today that are going to university are already there. But with all these different other types of tech training and it can happen all through the year that they go away and they join a group of people living in a house. So they need to be always aware of what they're getting themselves into. And so if you want accommodation for in the city, for example, for only, you know, 3 months, that's only temporary accommodation, really, isn't it? Mm. And that, but landlords do have those sort of setups, and it's all part of the agreement. Mm. You can have a long-term agreement or a short-term agreement, so you need to be really aware of what you're getting yourself into.
And I think, you know, to be fair to the tenancy servers, they've done a lot of homework. They've based all these on groundwork and past history to make it easier for the tenant and the landlord.
Mm.
It's not one or the other. They're were the mediators between tenancy and landlord. At the same time, you know, it is worthwhile knowing your rights, both as a tenant and as a landlord. It's surprising how many landlords are not up to date on their requirements of what they need to do if they actually own a property. And again, you know, come into the CAB landlords and get your copies.
Yes.
I mean, I know you can be scav savvy and on the internet and all that, but you know, sometimes it's good just to have a hard copy.
Well, that's right. And the tenancy service is very helpful. Mm. And they've got what to do if you're a landlord to check with the tenant to see if they're aware they've missed payments.
Yes.
Talk to them about what's happening. I mean, keep a conversation going. Yeah. Keep a...
communication.
Yeah,
open
exactly.
Communication. Yeah. And I think this is a thing. You know, it's you know, that landlord has got property that he's agreed to let out to rent. I mean, and you want to live in certain conditions, and part of that is for you to look after that property. But if anything goes wrong, you know, you call on your landlord and say, well, we've got a pipes burst. Well, hey, you get onto it pretty quick.
Well, there are all sorts of rules around what a landlord can do, telling you and notifying you when he wants to do a property check, and it's all in the original agreement. When you are renting a property and you're paying the rent, it's basically your right, and it's not the right of the landlord to come onto your property willy-nilly anytime he likes, but he has a right to make sure to be aware if you're not looking after that property. If that is the other thing, if you have difficulty, you can let them add an amount to their regular rent if they've, you know, had trouble paying. But the other thing that I find very helpful is if you can't reach an agreement, and this is the landlord, you can send a notice to remedy if the tenant owes less than 21 days rent. So you can actually tell them that you can remedy it with if they owe less than 21 days, and or you can apply to the tenancy tribunal for a termination of the tenancy if the tenant owes over 21 days of rent or more and doesn't remedy the overdue rent. So you've got to be very careful how you handle these things if you're a landlord, but there are steps in place.
I mean, there's even steps in place that you can actually download a letter to say basically what you need to say to the tenant or the landlord, isn't there? I mean, it really is bulletproof in some ways of how to deal with issues where they come up.
Oh, you see, on their website, there's a notice to remedy information and templates. So you've got it there that you can look at it. Now, if you can't download something, well, there you are. You can come into Citizens Advice and we'll download it for you.
And I think as a tenant, if something's happened and you're struggling, you can't meet that rent, be honest with the landlord and say, look, I'm a bit short this week, but I can make it up the next week.
Yeah.
You know, try and be honest. I think honestly, we, you know, if you come forward and say, look, such and such has happened, or this has happened, or this is, you know, I think, again, most people, if they know what's going on, are more lenient and more supportive.
Yes, I could agree on that. But let's face it, a lot of the rental properties are managed by property managers.
That's true.
So they are charged with collecting the rent.
And they're, well, they're contracted as well to the landlord. Yes. So they have got a different contract of obtaining the rent, literally, things like that. It can get quite complex, can't it?
It can.
Yeah.
Our best advice is as soon as you know something's not right and you can't pay or you're going to find it difficult, is to let that person know so that an allowance can be made.
And I think that goes the same with car payments, or other type of payments that you may be struggling with at a time. Yeah. Again, if you get in touch with them and let people know what's going on, they're more likely to work with you to resolve it than if you just keep mum, don't say a thing, and then it all blows up.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you know, it's... And I think maybe people feel that they're ashamed because they can't do it, or they're trying to deny it's not happening, or whatever it is. It's like, no, just come forward. Yeah.
Now, I'm looking at what advice they're giving for if you're a tenant. And so if you've missed a payment or you're having difficulty paying, contact, just what we've said, landlord immediately. You should pay whatever you can straight away. A part payment is better than nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Don't avoid to ignore your landlord's calls or messages. Mm. Be honest with them, and this is exactly what we've just been talking about. They may let you add an amount to your regular rent until you've paid the debt.
Yep.
So...
And often this is a time where if you are struggling, you actually go to a budget service as well, because often they can help you to support you to keep the agreements as well.
Yeah. Yeah. So in other words, if you had a terrible couple of weeks and you just didn't have the full amount of rent to go through.
Yeah, you may have gone off sick for a couple of weeks and you've used up your 5 days sick leave and you've not got any pay coming in that week.
And you you let them know and they can say, well, if you can pay so much, and then when you get back to work and you just have to tighten your belt a bit and pay a little bit more so to catch up, that's what they mean.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if you think trouble paying in the future, think about options.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can check with your tenancy agreement that and see if it allows you a paying boarder or flatmate.
Mm.
So we get some inquiries about that, people wanting to take on a boarder. And they ask us things like, how much should they charge?
Mm.
Well, we're not really able to say, because we don't, you know, no. We can suggest guidelines. And you can, the other thing is you can get in touch with a budgeting service or other agencies to see what support is available. And the other option is to think about whether you can afford to stay in the tenancy or if you need to explore cheaper options. Mm. I think people are very frightened to try and move out because there's just,
not much there. Yeah.
So,
and it might mean that you've got to go home to mum and dad for a while until you sort yourselves. That's life. You know, that is life today.
Yes.
You know, but just remember that if you do have to go home and your mum and dad have got used to not having you there, they've made a life for themselves and moved on. So it can be quite a shock to both sets of people to go home and live together again.
Both sides of the
and then having to be answerable to parents again as well. Anyway, Wesley, we're actually sort of coming up to our time. I'm not sure. Goodness. Is there anything else that we would like to just quickly catch up with?
No,
I don't think so.
I don't think so. One little thing.
Mm.
If the people out there listening and belong to a club or a sports club, a sewing group, any sort of community group that think that they may not be on our database, give us a call or pop in to the Bureau and give us some details, and we can check whether we've got you on our database, because at this moment we are updating all the local data because the way CAB works now, any Bureau in the country can look on our database and they can find out who does what, whether it be a sewing group,
a dancing group,
and you think, well, why would somebody in, for example, Auckland want to know about a social group in the Wairarapa. Well, they may be thinking of coming to live here. And they might think, well, I wonder what's there in this town that would interest us. So that's why we have our, and that's why we're updating that data.
There you are.
And because of quite a few changes, we are a bit behind on checking. So if something's changed in your club, please let us know before we actually ring you. Would be really helpful.
Yeah.
Yes.
So basically we say you can help us by getting in contact with us.
That's
at the
right.
CAB.
Yeah.
On 06377. Here we are.
0078.
That's correct.
Yes.
Anyway, well, thank you for listening to us, just us two. It's quite strange without our guests, I will admit. But yeah, it makes my brain sometimes having to think a little bit more.
Well, yeah, and it's some, you know, it's a great organisation. I'm very proud to be part of Citizens Advice. We do have our ups and downs and we have a few problems at times, but as a team we work very well together.
Yeah. And we are always, doors always open.
Oh, and one other thing, we do have a JP service that is not every day, but we have a JP who works once a week. Mostly, and we're looking to improve that service. So watch this space.
Well, all of you take care out there, and thank you for listening, and we'll see you again soon.
The Citizens Advice Bureau is where you talk and we listen.
But here on Cab Talk, we talk and you listen. Cab Talk, every Tuesday at 10 o'clock on Arrow FM.
Always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing.